What's happening, people? Back with another reaction, back with some more Depeche Mode. And we're going to listen to a bonus tune, or a sort of B-side track, from the Some Great Reward era. Once again, shout out to Han Solo for making all sorts of material available, even specifically within Depeche Mode. And the tune, I've never heard it before, which, again, I know Depeche Mode from this era, but as we've gone through a lot of these sort of extra tracks, it occurs to me that I really only knew the studio albums over the years. Now, it's sort of an exception. I have two of the compilations, People Are People and Catching Up with Depeche Mode, which I've had for a while. But on those compilations, there's a couple album tracks that, you know, I already knew. There's a few others, but there's obviously a lot of other tunes that they put out during this time that I just never ended up hearing because they weren't played on the radio and I didn't have them on the, like, cassette tapes of the albums that I had. So, in any case, we're going to listen to a tune that is called, parenthetically, for the first part of the title, Set Me Free. And then the normal part of the title is called Remotivate Me. So, you know, Remotivate Me stands out, the idea that one had been motivated in the past, but one has now entered a sort of a nadir or low point of one's enthusiasm or commitment to something. So the idea of being remotivated is interesting because it suggests a timeline, a sort of like a sequence of events. But Set Me Free as a sort of like refrain or an exclamation, it speaks to, you know, one's awareness that one is not, you know, functioning at the highest level or with the greatest motivation that one can. It maybe suggests a personal condition in which one knows one needs, you know, a sort of, you know, maybe a muse or maybe a catalyst, something or someone in one's life that can help them break this, you know, motivational malaise. So perhaps, you know, it won't be particularly relevant. There are obviously some of their tunes where the lyrics are perhaps less important to what the story that the Sonics are telling. So we'll find out. This is Set Me Free, as I said, parenthetically, and then Remotivate Me.
Set me free. Set me free.
I know this one. I've heard this.
Yeah.
that more. Lifelong Depeche Mode fan. I was already into their music by this point, but you know, I was like 5 years old, so essentially, you know, I couldn't be into like, you know, single culture and like 12-inch remix culture. I just, you know, wasn't old enough to be buying records or to sort of, you know, realize that there were tracks that were coming out that were not part of the albums, which again, like, they probably had single cassette tapes, but for whatever reason, like, I just keyed in on the albums. And it was probably because I was like basically asking, you know, my sister was into this kind of music a great deal, and I probably was just like, oh, so what's their next album? Well, that? Okay, so that's what I'm going to go looking for the next time I go to buy a tape. So, because I mentioned, you know, Christmas Island, I hadn't heard that one, and there were a couple people who were, like, really surprised by that, which, again, I get that, but at the same time, I was a wee tot, so as I got older, there were just tunes that, like, I didn't know when they came out, so I didn't know to look for them, you know what I mean? It's like, if you don't know something's there to be found, you're not really going to go looking for it, so... it'll be an interesting journey as I go through these album folders and see, you know, what other sort of B-sides and rarities are on offer. Once again, shout out to Han Solo. Do let me know what you think of this one. I will see you next time. Peace.